Hi there. In this tutorial, we're going to be covering how to some example two examples on how to actually generate your cut and path sets. So we're going to go ahead and start off like this. Let's say you have a Boolean decision diagram that looks like this. Top event. OR gate, OR vent here, another OR gate. Might notice that this can be simplified a bit, but this is another OR gate. This is a AND gate. Here's a event here. AND gate, event, event. AND gate to a AND gate, then two events here, and OR gate with event, event. The first thing you're going to do is label the gates plus events. And I'm going to use this notation 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and to make things interesting, 5 and 6. You notice that 5, 5, 6, 6, these are in duplicate. It's just the same event, but different gates triggering them. And we'll use the gate notation G naught, G one, G two, G three, G four, G5 and G6. So this is a fault tree. So we're going to say, or we say, just remember that OR, this is plus, and this is multiply, sort of thing. So we say T equals G naught. We're going to say G naught equals 1 plus G 1 plus 2. G 1 equals G 2 plus G 3. We're going to go ahead and substitute that in. 1 plus G 2 plus G 3 plus 2, so we'll substitute that in. 1 plus, rearrange things, G3. Okay, so keep going. The idea is you want to get in the end a sum of products. And then we're going to say G2 equals G4 plus G. I'm sorry. G2, this is an AND gate, so we have G2 equals G4, G5. G4 is an OR gate. Or let's just go with G3 to keep in kind of order. G3, it's an OR gate, so that equals 3 plus G6. And then G4, That's an OR gate, so that's 4 plus 5. G5 is a AND gate, so that's 6, 7, which means that this whole thing equals 4 plus 5, 6, 7, times 6, 7, which equals 4, 6, 7 plus 5, 6, 7. Plus sign there. I know it's a little crowded. 4, 6, 7 plus 5, 6, 7. So that's G2, so we can. And then G6, I know this is getting a little bit unorganized, equals 5, 6. So let's just go ahead and write this stuff down here. We're going to say T equals 1 plus 2 plus G2 plus G3, which equals 1 plus 2 plus, we said G2 equals 4, 6, 7 plus 5, 6, 7. We said G3 equals 3 plus G6. 3 plus G6, well, that's just 3 plus 5, 6. So plus G3 equals 3 plus 5, 6. I don't know why this is in parentheses. So we now have no longer gates in there, so our final cut set is going to equal 1 plus 2 plus 4, 6, 7 plus 5, 6, 7 plus 3 plus 5, 6. Did I actually mention that what we're doing is generating a cut set? So the reason why this is a cut set is that our top event is a failure. So all the initiating events are failures of events. So this is our final minimal cut set. Okay. Now, what if we want to go from cut set to path set? What you're going to do is you're going to take this diagram here, and all the OR gates go to AND gates, and all the AND gates go to OR gates. So cut to path, or you know, this is bidirectional really, so you can say AND, just switch that with OR, and OR, switch that with AND, depending on which way you're going. So we're going to redraw this thing, and you're going to say top. Here's a AND gate. Here's another OR goes to AND. We have an OR gate, an AND gate here, so this becomes an OR gate. And we have a OR gate here, so this becomes a AND gate. And we have an OR gate here, which becomes an AND gate. And we have a AND gate here, which becomes an OR gate. And we have an event here, here, here. This AND gate becomes an OR gate. Event, 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 event. Now, here I call them a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, but if you have a graphing calculator or Wolfram Alpha, if you label this A, B, C, D, E, F, G, it's a C, EF, you can get Wolfram Alpha or your graphing calculator to expand out the equations we're going to make. So we say, and this is G naught, G1, G2, G3, G4, G5, and G6. It's a 6. So we say T equals G naught. Well, that equals A times B times G1, which equals A times B times G2, G3, which equals AB, G2, that's going to equal, it's an OR gate, so G4 plus G5, and G3, this is C plus G6. Continuing to expand this out, AB, G4 equals D, E plus F plus G. That's an OR gate there, so it's plus. C plus G6 is an OR gate, so we have E plus F. So if we expand this out using our calculators or Wolfram Alpha or whatever, or by hand, hope God we don't have to do it by hand, we get something like this, A, B, C, D, E squared plus A, B, C, E, F. Just copying this down so there might be a mistake in there. A, B, C, E, G plus A, B, C, D, E, F plus A, B, C, F squared plus A, B, C, F, G. See the square terms? Remember that I said A dot A equals A, so they just get reduced down to no squares. And this is our final answer. So that's two examples on how to generate a cut and path set. Next tutorial, we'll be going over Nelson's method.